Hi, my name is Ayshi, and today I'm going to read out the second story of Tenali Raman. I hope you liked my previous story. Today's the name of the story is Going to Court. Raman lost no time in telling everyone about his plans. His friends jeered at him while his mother, used to Raman's unpredictable ways, made no comment. One difficulty, however, Raman struck. How could he barge into Krishnadevaraya's court without a patron or a recommendation? While pondering on a solution, Raman married Mangamma, a distant relative, much to the amazement of his friends and the delight of his mother. Shortly after Raman's wedding, Tatachari, the pompous royal priest at Krishnadevaraya's court, came to worship at the shrine of Mangalgiri near Tenali. When Raman heard this, he decided that here lay the solution to his problem. Raman lost no time in ingratiating himself with the priest. He fetched and carried and served Tatachari every day. When the day of the priest's departure dawned, Tatachari, possibly out of a desire to show Raman how powerful he was at the court, said that whenever Raman wanted a job at the Vijayanagar court, he had only to ask him. Even before the dust raised by Tatachari's carriage had settled, Raman was scampering home to ask his mother and wife to pack all their belongings. They left the following morning, and after a wearing journey of many days, reached the great city. Raman feasted his eyes on the broad streets, a huge shop, the massive temples, the displays of jewelry and silk, and the majestic elephants and chariots. He rejoiced at the amazing turn his future had taken. When Raman presented himself at Tatachari's house, however, he was not granted an audience. He must be tired after his journey, thought Raman cheerfully, and resolved to come back the following day. Yet, he faced the same refusal the next morning, and the next, and the next. Tatachari's good intention had clearly been shorter than the journey between Tenali and Vijayanagar. Finally, one day, one of the guards told him that Tatachari had no idea who he was and he should cease to bother him. Hurt and bewildered, Raman refused to be defeated by this obstacle. He dug out his best clothes and made his way to Krishnadevaraya's court. As it happened, that morning there was a great debate between scholars on the reality of objective phenomena. As a result, the main hall was thronged with people from many cities who had been invited to watch the battle of wits. No guards questioned the stranger as he managed to slip in with the other invitees. Raman's luck seemed to be finally turning. Though it was hard to stop staring at the grand room with its orient ceilings and decorated pillars, and to focus on two short, fat men arguing doggedly, Raman tried his best. He kept getting distracted by trying to catch glimpses of Krishnadevaraya and by imagining himself as one of the grandly dressed men sitting by the king, occasionally leaning forward to hear his comments. When he finally managed to focus his attention on the debate again, one scholar was insisting that the world was an illusion.
It is our thoughts alone that make us think we are seeing, hearing, tasting, smelling, and touching things, he declared grandly.
The perplexity on everyone's face was evident, but they all applauded politely as the scholar sat down with a satisfying air. Raman could not contain himself. Pushing himself to the front of the crowd, he said loudly, "Sir, is there no difference between our eating a thing and thinking that we are eating?"
"None,"
replied the scholar. "In that case," said Raman boldly, addressing the audience at large, "let's test this man's theory. Let's all eat the rich feast provided by the man and let this man think that he is eating it and fill his stomach." A roar of appreciative laughter followed. Raman suddenly found himself face to face with the king. For the first time in his life, he found himself stammering slightly while introducing himself to the impressive, dignified figure before him, whose eyes gleamed with genuine enjoyment. Would the king be angry at his cheeky intrusion? Has he overstepped some line or what? Then he became aware that the king was addressing him. "Raman of Tenali," said Krishna Devarai, holding out a purse of gold, "I am pleased by your wit. You will be my court jester from now. Take this money and buy yourself a house and whatever else you need." A thrill of triumph shot through Raman and sudden tears filled his eyes. It had been a long journey to his goal, and one that had been fraught with uncertainty. And he had sometimes wondered whether he was merely chasing an illusion. Yet, it had been worth for it. At long last, his dream had been fulfilled, and that was all that mattered. The end. Thank you, and please do subscribe and share this video. Of course, comment down below if you want me to read other stories. And please click on the like button and switch on the notification for all the videos that we're gonna send. Bye now!